Hall under center, man in motion to the right side. He'll hand to Miller. Fumble, loose ball at midfield. Looks like LVC has it. LVC was right there when that ball fell down.
I thought Gilchrist was going to be on it, but he was not. But somebody else got on the bottom.
You're right, it was Gilchrist.
He still fought everyone. He didn't even have the best vantage point, but he is ridiculously strong, and he's a ball hawk out there. Alex Gilchrist, the senior. Aaron Palmieri, Mark Russell, Butch Krieger, and Chris Korn is the secondary.
There's a snap, and Giles up the middle, big hole, gets down to the end zone, but flags are thrown. No one moved. The ball was snapped, but no one moved, so I don't see how they can throw flags on it offside here. Once that ball snaps, but no one was moving. This is what's
offside. Offside Grove City. Touchdown.
Yeah. Touchdown for Giles. 18 yards. It was odd because it was almost like no one moved from 10. Slot to the near side from their own 36. Backs in the eye with a deep back being Giles. He'll go again, this time looking to go left. Now decides to cut it outside at the 40. 45, 50, 45, 40, and knocked out of bounds in Grove City territory at the 40-yard line.
Yeah, give him a couple of carries and let Ben Giles do what he does best, which is read the play. He saw an opening to the outside and chose to bounce it. And Grove City, the Wolverines defense, overcommitted to the inside of the point of attack. That
shotgun for Hall. Trips to the far side. Split on the near side. Hall's going to roll to the left. Got pressure and forget about it. He's buried back at the 38-yard line. Gilchrist, the Undertaker there.
And the reason it works is because, as I had said earlier, Gilchrist, they have been using him pretty much exclusively all year so far in coverage. All of a sudden, the surprise blitz from the strong side backer. Here he comes in the backfield. Hall never saw him. Dropped in his step.
And GoDutchman.com. First and 10, Grove City. And the quarterback, Groves, has the ball. Check that. It is Hall back in there. And the ball comes back to him. He was not ready for it. And has to pick it up. And he is down back of the 17.
He's in the shotgun. Visitor side is actually full as well.
Indeed. Vic back to pass. In the pocket, throws down the right side. He's got Giles, caught at the 35, 30, 25, 20, 15, 10. Tripped up from behind at the 7-yard line of Grove City. A 41-yard pass from Fick to Ben Giles.
And they snuck him out of the backfield. And a great deceptive play call as they motioned to Giles going to the right. The pass play seemed like it was going to come back to the other side, and then all of a sudden, backdoor, Giles sneaking out of the backfield, beats the linebacker.
Third and 7. He'll pitch it out to the left side, and Miller gets tripped up by Gilchrist. Again, getting that outside penetration. He'll lose a couple. It brings up a fourth down, back around the 20-yard line, and the punting unit comes in for Grove City.
The formation hurt Grove City because Gilchrist had the slot man, Will McCoy.
Third line. Hall is under center, lone setback, and Hall's going to keep it and is tackled back at the 1-yard line.
Alex Gilchrist came around the outside, and the comfort level for LVC, knowing that Grove City's going to run the football, Gilchrist knows he's got support inside. His job is to make sure that nobody gets around the corner, and Hall wasn't getting anywhere near the corner.
Trips on the right side on 3rd and 5. Fick's going to roll to the right, looking, throws for Giles. He'll catch it far side inside the 40. First down out of bounds at the 36. It was a high pass. He had to leap and pull it in.
Yeah, but that's a great throw from Fick for this reason. He had a defensive player in between himself and Giles and needed to make sure that there was no chance of that ball getting knocked down. He lobbed it to a place where only Giles could make the catch.
Grove City. Giles behind Kirchner. They'll put two tight ends on the right side. They'll hand to the right side. Giles looking for room. Cuts it at the goal line. And touchdown. 1 yard. Touchdown run. He had to work for it. But Giles able to get it. And LVC's back in front 13-10.
And the perception of running backs like Giles who have that great breakaway speed is, well, they're scat backs. They're guys who cannot really power. Ben Giles is no small back, 6 foot, 189 pounds, and he used all the strength he could muster that time. There was definitely pressure there, and He was able to get to see 190 on the ground, 85 through the air for 275.
Oh, here is a pass by Hall. Gilchrist read it perfectly. Cut in front of the intended receiver on the side of Reith. And he just jumped in the air and batted it on. As he hit the ground, he almost pulled down the football with him.
That's
second and 10, the 15. Quick little pitch to the right side to Miller. Forget about that. Blyler is back there to take him down for a loss of four.
It's nice to hear that call of Blyler out of you, because we haven't heard it very much this season. Teams running away from him sometimes. That can be frustrating, but he's had a difficult time getting going. That play, one-on-one against offensive linemen, sheds his blocker, gets in the backfield, and just...